Now I'm going to continue with a call out. We want to create something such as this. So how about I go here? This time I want to use the call out option. Something like this. Okay. This is going to be the foundation detail, or section detail at foundation. Okay, now it's a good idea to change this to fine. Maybe we can change this to hidden line. That would make more sense. And the scale is good. We can also go with like 125 or something. If I use TL to show thick lines and thin lines, it would be easier to follow the cut patterns here. Now let's see, I don't want to see that column in the background. So how about under the properties of the callout, I go here. We have option for crop view, annotation crop, for clip offset. How about I reduce that number maybe to 1000. Parent view, okay. I wanna go with independent and then I can change this number. Okay, now I can only see what's going on in here. Okay, that's better. And this is the floor. So what this detail is telling us is that we had some miscalculations and the floor is not attached to the wall that it should be. See here, we are not exactly doing that. So I want to go to level 1, edit boundary. I'll go to floor plan, level 1, and I want to change this to wireframe. We can put these two views side by side by using WT. And actually it's the other side, it's the other one in here. I can use a line, select this line and align this with that. Yes, that's fixed now. And I can align that with that. Okay, now it's better. Again, no. Okay, so callout is useful to show us the mistakes that we have had. Okay, so now it's good. I can add a layer of rigid insulation here. What I want to do here is that I want to use some detail line in here. So I'm going to go to annotate. I'm going to go with the region, field region. We already had one. I want to edit type, duplicate, and go with rigid insulation. That's good. In this one, I don't want to have any background color. That should be good. Okay, I can draw a region in here maybe. I need to go to edit type. This is the pattern, right? Uh, this is the pattern. How about I go with a horizontal pattern because it's rotated by 90 degrees. Or this one even. Okay, that's a bit better. You can switch to teal. So that part is outside, that part is inside. We also have some insulation on the inside here, right? So maybe I could create that too. How about I select this, go to edit type, go to edit, and on the inside, if I change this to plan, on the inside, I want to insert a layer, move it down so it's on the interior side. Change this to more like a substrate, and it's going to be rigid insulation. Rigid insulation. Okay. How about I go with 4 inches and we'll see if that one is good. Okay, that's okay. Apply it. Actually, yeah, maybe I could go here and move this up. Okay, and apply that. It seems better. It's about right. Okay. So I have the insulation there and the wall up there. We can add some details. Some annotations. I'm gonna go to tag by category and I can tag this wall, move the tag over there like this. And this is the wall. I need to select the wall, go to edit type, and I can rename it by like exterior curtain wall. Or as it says here, building envelope window wall. I can do that too. Okay. So now I want to change the scale a little bit, 1 to 25, and TL is on, good. I can work with this, okay, and maybe I could go with edit family, and I can change this dimension to 17, so it's doubled. And I can move this here. I can also change this to 17. Okay, move this to the middle. And for the text, I can go to edit type and change the text size. Maybe to 1 or 1.5 millimeter. Okay, and change it here to 1.5. Okay, I want to load this back into project, override it, and it works a bit better. It's a little bit too small, so I'm gonna go to edit type again. I'm going to actually go to edit family, and I'm gonna select this. Edit type, rename this as 2 millimeter or even 2.5 should work, and change this to 2.5. Apply, okay, load into project and override it. A bit better, 2 millimeter should be the best. So I'm gonna go back here, go to edit type, rename it as 2 millimeter. load into project and override it. Now it's the best. Okay. We can keep adding more information here. I can tag by category. I can tag this wall, and I can go to edit type and assign something to the type mark here. This is my concrete footing. I'm gonna put the type mark to be concrete footing. Okay. I can add some text over there by using this. Annotate text here. Or here maybe. I want to add some text over there, and I want to write rigid insulation. Okay, that seems good. I also want to add this note in here. Maybe I can move this down. And I want to add one other text here. And I want to add a vapor barrier. Okay, better. How about I make this a little bit bigger and move this away? And it should go to here. Go to here. Okay, so I have the insulation over there, the barrier, the vapor barrier is here. That's rigid insulation. Okay, I could also show this dimension here, from here to here. Now I want to add a text in here. This is the concrete slab, 4 inches. Okay, I'm gonna move this up here and move this to here. Move this a little bit more. And I wanna add one more layer of text here to indicate the rigid insulation. And I want to show this dimension in here, from here to here. And I want to add a note. I want to add a note here. Okay, how about I move this here and move the note here. Okay. A bit better, so is the concrete off stance minimum 8 inches. Okay. And I want to add one more note here for seal flashing, as we have here. So we have that wall type, we have that wall type here, and we have seal flashing, concrete upstand, rigid insulation, concrete slab, insulation. And it's important also to mention here that we have damp proofing. So Let me copy this dotted line here to show dotted text line here to show damproofing. I can move this a bit close. Okay, so this makes sense now. I can move this a bit inside. Okay, better. All is good. That part is good. I can move this up and I can move this inside. We can check how it looks like if we change this to shaded, which is not too bad. If you wanna send it to like city or something, being colored is not the best option, so you might go with black and white. But if it's just for demonstration, you can go with shaded.